example. Just get what is U and is H. We can note this. U of T is T squared I minus 2TJ. Then H of T, 2 over TI minus J. So H of U of T, H of U of T would be U I minus J. H of T. So let's go down. So we want now to differentiate U of F of T. So what we have is U of, just a minute, let me just, we are using U of F of T. Sorry, I used H of U. It should be U of F of T. So U of T, I minus 2TJ. Then F of T is 3T. So U of F of T, U of F of T would be I minus 2FJ. And remember, F is 3 of T. So U of F of T will be 3T squared I minus 2 times 3TJ, which is 3T squared. This is 3T squared because it is 3 times T. So ideally that is 9T squared I minus 60J. Computing of T, then we see what we are differentiating at the end. So if we are to differentiate, what would the function would be differentiating is 9T squared I minus 60J. So of course if we differentiate 9T squared I, we'll get 18T I. Then if we differentiate negative, we get 6J. But using the procedure up here, we are saying ddt of U of F of T of we have done. This is what we've done basically. Ddt of 9t squared I minus 60j. The alternative ddt of U of T is du df times df dt. Now our df dt will be d of 3t because f of t is that is. Then u of t is t squared I minus 2tj. So u of f will be squared times I minus f times j. Now du df, differentiate u with respect to f, f along I minus 2j. Now du dt of d of u of f t will be du df, which you have computed here, and df dt. So du df is 2fi minus 2j. So this will give us 2 times f. We have substituted back the value of f, and f of t was 3t. 2 times 3 of t along I minus 2 by 3. And this gives us 18 ti minus 6 j, which is the same result if we had composed the function first and then differentiated. Example number 11, we are given a vector r of t in three dimensions, and we are supposed various derivatives. So the first derivative of r with respect to t, so differentiate of the component, of course we get the result here. Number b is derivative of r with respect to twice, so we differentiate A once, that's the same as differentiating R twice. So D differentiate I cos T, we get minus I sin T, differentiate minus sin T, we get minus cos T, and we differentiate cos T, we get zero. So the second has no component along z. Dr dt, that's the magnitude of dr dt. So the Pythagorean theorem, cos squared t plus sine squared t plus 1 squared, we are squaring the components. Remember, the negative sine t squared will be the same as sine squared t, because negative 1 squared will be 1. So again, cos t plus sine squared t, that's the Pythagorean identity, which is 1. So this gives us the root of 2. So the magnitude of dr dt will be root 2. Magnitude of d squared r dt squared, we are getting the magnitude of the dt. So we expect sine squared t plus squared t. And basically, take the square root of that, and you are doing square root of 1. Those are some of the applications of the derivatives. The other application will be in the computation of the normal tangent and also the binomial vectors. We are defining the unit tangent. Before the unit tangent is the tangent, first of all. Remember, we have a smooth curve, r of t. Then the derivative, if the derivative is not, then that curve, r prime of t, that is dr dt. What we are remembering is that of a function f of x. If you differentiate the function, a curve f of x at any point, basically you are getting the to the curve at that point. So that is the theory we are bringing to the description of curves. So if we have a smooth curve t, then r prime of t gives us the tangent vector to that curve any given point. So if we substitute the value of t at any point, then we get the tangent vector to the curve at that point. Now the unit tangent vector, and we use capital T of t for the unit tangent vector, the standard. This is defined the vector, which is r prime of t divided by its magnitude. So if we get the tangent and divide by its magnitude, then we get one unit tangent vector. Definition, this is the unit tangent vector. Number two is the principal normal vector. Again, if you have this smooth curve r of t on an open interval, and the derivative of unit tangent vector is not zero, excuse me. Then the normal vector, the principal unit normal vector, it is unit in nature, so it's a unit vector, is given by derivative of the unit vector divided the unit tangent vector derivative with its magnitude, get the unit normal vector. It's important to note here that principal unit normal vector is perpendicular to the unit tangent vector. So the normal and the tangent are perpendicular to each other. Some particular examples. Suppose the space curve is given by R of t equal to t plus t squared j. What would be the tangent vector and what would be the principal normal? So our R of t is ti plus t squared j. And we are computing this at the point when t, again, the second is also given here. And we also need the tangent and the normal vector, both units. So the first step will be to differentiate the space curve, r prime of t or d dt of r. So we get that as plus a. The magnitude of r prime would be the square of the component 1, the square of the component here, which is 2t. So that will give us the square root of 1 plus 4t squared. The unit tangent vector by tangent vector divided by its magnitude. So vector, our tangent vector is I plus A. Then the magnitude is the square root of 4t squared. So if we divide its magnitude, we get the unit. In particular, if small t is 1, then the vector at 1, evaluated at 1, be 1 over the square root of 1 plus 4 times 1 squared, 1 plus 2 times 1, 1 over root 5 times I plus 2j. Then it's tangent vector at t equal to 1. Number B is the unit vector, and we have said we differentiate tangent vector. So differentiating tangent vector given in the square bracket, this is our unit tangent vector in bracket here. We differentiate that, of course, using the quotient rule, and we know how to do that. We get the derivative will give us this quantity here. The magnitude of t prime of t be the magnitude of this quantity. The note is not straightforward, that we compute the magnitude, so that if you divide the tangent unit vector, so t of derivative, which is here, would give you the normal vector. Let's, which is evaluated to the end. So the tangent vector, derivative of space curve r of t, which is 3i plus 4tj, magnitude of the tangent will be root 9 plus 16t squared. Then the unit tangent vector is the tangent vector r of t divided by its magnitude, and each of these is computed. So 1 over square root of 9 plus 16t squared times 3i plus 4tj. And t is 1, the tangent unit tangent vector to be 1/5 the times 3i plus we are substituted small t with 1. Again, this complete because we need now the normal vector. We need the normal vector, which is t prime of t. We differentiate this quantity here, quantity with respect to t, then compute its magnitude. Then the normal vector by definition, the tangent vector, unit tangent vector, t prime of t divided by the magnitude of the derivative of the unit tangent vector. Sorry, this is not complete. We need to work on that. And now, let's look at another example we used interesting here. Let's look at the next example where we have given let me see if it's solved to the end first. So we want tangents and okay. Consider this, which is solved. Find the tangent line, the principal normal vector x. So of course, notice here we want the tangent, which is r prime of t. But the principal unit normal unit tangent vector. So although we are not asked for the unit tangent vector, we will definitely have to compute that. The tangent line and principal normal to this curve, which is an helix at this point, where t is pi over 4. So this is given in that form. The derivative of r of t is minus 2 sine t I plus 2 cos t j plus k. Notice the way I'm presenting this. This is intentional. Please don't write minus 2 tj because this would mean that you are computing the sine of tj. You have to write that. I would that you put the two, the sine t bracket to write j after t. You better as sine of t. Put bracket, then write J. We don't think that you're T times I. Again, I've written 2J cos T and not 2 cos TJ. Please note that so that it is very clear. So this is the derivative of R of T. Magnitude of that, so you square minus 2 sine to get square 2 cos t to get that, square 1 to get 1. Again, sine squared t plus cos squared t is 1. So if you write the sum of these two as 4 times sine squared t plus cos squared t, that will give you a 4 plus 1. So this is root 5. Now, t of t, so what you are required to get r prime of t tangent vector. This is the tangent vector. The first equation here. The first equation here gives us vector. Why are we doing all this? Because for the normal vector, we will need t of t. So that's why we are working with the magnitude and getting the tangent. So when pi t small is pi over 4, then the t of t will give 1/√5 evaluated with 4. So pi over 4 cos pi over 4. This gives us cosine pi over 4 is root 2 over 2, which is the same as cos pi over 4, which is root 2 over 2. So if we evaluate that, you get this expression at the end, 1 over root 5, root 2i plus root 2j plus k. So that is the tangent vector at t. Now, why are we breaking here? So our t of t, remember t of t was here, t of t, the unit tangent vector. So here the unit vector, that is what we are doing here. We get 1 over root 5 times minus 2t minus 2j sine t. Of course, the derivative of the constant will be 0. The magnitude of this quantity will be the square of root 5 into plus 2 cos t all squared plus minus 2 all squared. So if you close out, you get that the magnitude of t prime is actually 2 over root 5. So that the number at t prime of t divided by its magnitude. And if we do that, then we get that the normal vector will be, if you simplify, you get minus I cos t minus j. That is the normal vector. And the next will be the binomial vector. What I shared didn't have the binomial vector. So I'll just share some material here for the binomial vector. Okay, I hope this is visible. We just increase the font. Yeah, this is the binomial vector. You can note that and take the example. You can note that and then we discuss the same. So if you can take this, this was not in the notes. Just take this where we are defining the binomial vector of a smooth curve R of t on some open interval as the vector b of t, that is denoted by b of t, and is defined by the cross product of the tangent, unit tangent vector t of t cross n of t, the unit normal vector. So ideally, remember we said the tangent vector t of t and n of t are perpendicular to each other. So t cross n, again by definition of cross product, should give us that is
T and N. So the binomial vector is perpendicular to the tangent vector. It is also perpendicular to the vector. So ideally, if you take a plane containing the tangent vector and the normal vector, then the binomial vector is perpendicular to this plane. Remember again, we said that A cross B is not the same as B cross A. So please note that the binomial vector is T cross N and not N. So this is T cross N. The tangent cross the normal vector will give us the binomial vector. So please take note of this. Also, you can take that example 14 and try to work out these quantities, the tangent vector, the normal vector, and now the binomial vector will be the cross product of what you get as a tangent vector and the normal vector. And then we can discuss that. So I allow you some few minutes to copy that and work it out, and then we can discuss it. Dixon, the attendance is appearing before top. That's why we are having the attendance. If you have issues, it's only that can sort it out. We expect that the attendance should be clear. So I hope you have been able to work this out. The tangent vector, that will be r prime of t. Of course, sheet you get that quantity minus I sine t plus j cos t plus k. The magnitude of that should be sine squared plus cos squared t plus 1 squared under root, which is ideally from the Pythagoras theorem. Cos squared t is 1, so that the magnitude is root 2. So the tangent vector will be the tangent vector r prime of t divided by the magnitude. So 1 over root 2 times the tangent vector gives us the unit tangent t of normal vector. Unit normal will be the derivative of the tangent, unit tangent vector by magnitude. If we differentiate the unit tangent, we get 1 over root 2, of course, minus I cos t minus j sine t plus 0. Get 1, we get 0. The magnitude of that, you work out, it is minus, it is actually 1 over root 2, the Pythagoras theorem there, so that the normal vector will be 1 over the magnitude of the unit tangent, which is 1 over root 2, times the tangent vector derivative, t prime of t. So if we work that out, you see that the normal vector is minus I cos t minus j sin t. Now, the normal vector we are saying is the cross product of the tangent, unit tangent with the normal. So again, using the determinant, I, j, k, the first is the tangent vector component. The third row is the normal vector component. Of course, the normal vector has no k component, so that's why you have a zero there. And if you compute that, you'll be able to see that the vector will be I sine t over root 2 minus j cos t over 2 k over root 2. So ideally, we have also used the Pythagoras theorem there on the last bit, as t over root 2 plus cos squared t over root 2, we can find out 2. Then we have sine squared t plus cos squared t, which is 1. So that is how we get 1 over 2. So that gives us the normal, the unit tangent vector, the unit normal vector, and the binormal vector. So that's it for lecture 4.
If you have any questions, you can raise them on the chat as we translate to the next slide, which is the one I have sent to you as lecture 5. So let us take some break. Let's take some break so that we shift to that and attend to a few things. Any questions can be raised. But resume after 15 minutes, please. Let's resume after 15 minutes. But any questions can be raised on the chat.